accordingly started. In yesterday's lecture, good morning everyone. Myself, Professor Smita A. Takarkar, as an assistant professor in ENTC department. Today we have taught about the subject of basic electronics engineering in unit 2. Yesterday's lecture I taught about the transistors applications, then history of transistor. There is a contents you can see on that, the transistor structure, it's a types of the transistor, like a PNP transistor and NPN transistor. Then you can see on that the terminal, there are three terminals you can use: base terminal, emitter terminal and the collector terminal. This emitter terminal and the base terminal, the emitter terminal you can use heavily doped, then base terminal is lightly doping and the collector terminal is moderate doping process in a transistor. That's, there are two types of the BJT: bipolar junction transistor. It is a two types. One is the NPN transistor, negative, positive, and the negative transistor, electrons, holes, electrons transistor. And the PNP transistor, you can see on the PNP transistor, this is the PNP hole, electrons, hole transistor, hole, and that is lightly doped for the normal emitter, and the collector is the moderate dope, and base terminal is the light dope. According to the current, there are three currents, there are three terminals we can using a three ways current flowing through the circuitry in a transistor of NPN transistor as well as PNP transistor, in a current of the base current, emitter current and the collector current. The emitter current is a sum of, it is a sum of collector current and base current. It is a sum of base current and the collector current is known as the emitter current. These currents you can flow, there are three junctions, two junctions. One junction is the base to collector junction, base to emitter junction, and another is the base to collector junction. There are three regions you can use in a PN junction at say equivalent circuit. If the diode or the region, it is used as a forward bias, negative, collector is the negative and the base is the positive, is the one B to C. Junction B to C is the forward bias, and the B to E, it is also forward bias. These regions you can use a 0.7 cutoff region in a transistor. Then second one, the terminal of B to C, it is a reversed bias. B to C, it is reverse bias, and the another junction B to E, it is also reverse bias. This transistor, the transistor goes to saturation region. If the forward, both the junctions, it is a forward bias, you can use for the saturation region. Both the junctions, it is a reversed bias, the transistor, it is a open switch, and it is a open switch in reverse bias, the transistor goes to cutoff region. And if the transistor for B to E, it is a forward bias, B base to emitter junction, you can use for the forward bias, it is used for the base to emitter, we can use forward bias, and base to collector junction, we can use in a reversed bias. the transistor, it acts as a closed switch and its current flowing through the whole circuitry. That's why the junction is formation in a PNP junction or NP, in the formation of the junction PN junction or NPN junction is the naming of emitter to base junction and base to collector junction. And this region is known as the active region. The maximum voltage will be increased in PNP circuitry or NPN circuitry. And it is possible amplifier in this active region. This part is covered in PNP. This is the transistor operation in PNP region. It is operated in PNP like a holes emitted, maximum holes, majority carrier in the form of the holes. The current is flowing. The circuitry of the emitter resistor in the first circuit and other circuits through the resistor, collector resistor through the current of IC. It is directly proportional to the collector current plus base current. Base is the common. Okay, this part is the cover in till then today's session, transistor configuration. It is depends on the terminal. There are three terminals. Switch terminal, terminal is the base terminal, emitter terminal, and the collector terminal. But here the common mode we can use in a transistor, there are two inputs and the two outputs. Means two ports, we can use a two ports, four terminal device. But the transistor it can identify only three terminals. Then how it is possible in a network, in a transistor configuration? Because one terminal, we can use a common terminal. Common terminal. You can see here, this is the transistor configuration circuitry. In a transistor configuration circuitry, here two inputs port. Port 1 and port 2, two port network, one port is assigned for the input and another port is assigned for the output. But it is a two directional, mean a bi-directional, two ports, it's at a time working in a two ports. Two port is the input and two port is the outputs, because it's required a four terminal network, because it required four terminal network. But the transistor, you can see here the symbol of transistor. The transistor, it is a three terminal device. One is the emitter, another is the base, and third is the collector. It is a three terminal device. Then how it is possible the transistor configuration in four terminal network? It is possible. It's convert two port, one input port and the another output port, two port and three terminal device at a time. Each terminal we can a common terminal, like a common base we can use for the NPN transistor as well as PNP transistor. Then another configuration, emitter configuration, the common terminal is the common emitter terminal, and it's a configuration of transistor, common emitter, NPN transistor, common emitter, PNP transistor. And then third one, the common collector terminal, because of the it is used as a three terminal configuration, like a common base configuration, common emitter configuration, and common collector configuration. Then after that, you can see the common base configuration. First, common base. Common base, base is the common, means it is a required two port network. One port is the emitter to supply. It is a input port. and output port collector to supply. This is another port. And two port is the port one input, another port is the output, and the three terminal device, emitter, base and the collector. But it is required a common one terminal. This is the naming of common base config. Common base configuration. Here you can see the common base configuration. Here the one emitter, it is a PNPN. N is the electrons emitted in an emitter region. Then P eats the holes. It can emitted with holes in a base terminal. And last one, the N. N is also electrons. It is connected through the collector terminal. The maximum majority carrier in the form of the charge electrons is created in a N region, negative charge. It is also electrons, it is created in a negative charge. But the P junctions, it is here a P junctions, it is created holes only. That's it's required. It's converted to the positive charge. But after the formation of junction, here the formation of junctions, how it is possible formation of junctions? It is similar for the PN junction. P, NP. First is the NP. N, here N. N and P. If the maximum electrons is moving right side of the P region. Maximum electrons is moving right side of the P region. This is terminal of emitter. I am talking about the emitter terminals only because of here two junction formation. One is the emitter to base junction and another is the base to collector junction. Then I am talking about only first junction, base to emitter junction. If the maximum electrons is moving right side of the holes, right side of the P region and combined with holes, it is created a It is combined with holes, that is known as recombination of the electrons and holes. Electrons and holes. And it's generated negative and the positive formation charge. Negative and positive formation of the charge, and it is N region, and in a N region it's created, after the formation it's created a positive charge in N region, and after the formation recombination of the P region it is created a negative charge, and it's a formation of junction. Negative charge of the electrons, positive charge of the electrons and negative charge of the holes, then current is flowing through the emitter. But here the supply, you can use a conventional anode is connected through the emitter resistor, and the cathode is connected to the base terminal. That's why current is flowing in a negative opposite of the electrons. Electrons is moving in a P region. All electrons is moving in a P regions, and P regions is created after the recombination. P region is a negative charge, and electrons is created moving all holes is N region. That's why in N region it is created a positive charge, and the all holes is flowing through the currents in emitter through the battery and battery through the base terminal. That's why electrons is moving opposite of the current. The electrons is moving one direction and the current is moving opposite directions of the current. That's why here generation of the junction based to emitter junction. Here maximum current is equational, that is meaning of the directional conventional current IE. Then second part of the PN, NPN transistor, NPN. In a first part is finished, NP transistor, then another is the PN, P and N region. Here the junction is formation based to collector junction. In the P region, after the recombination of electrons, this N region is created a positive charge and the holes is created a negative charge. Then the current is flowing through the circuitry. According to the base terminal, here the common base, some current is flowing through the emitter, some current is flowing through the collector terminal. Then according to the after formation of junction, the P region is created negative charge and N region is created positive charge. Then the collector current IC, the collector current IC is equal to the injected collector current. What is mean by injected? Injected is maximum electrons flowing through the collector terminal. Maximum electrons, because the electrons in a negative, the electrons in a N region, it's doping emitter terminal heavily doped. And it is also collector terminal, maximum electrons is flowing through the N region. It is also moderate dope. B, in this circuitry, common base configuration. Base is common. Base is common means it is connected through the ground. It is connected through the ground. And the maximum current is flowing through the collector current as well as emitter current. The voltage is increases, the current is also increases. Voltage is increases, here current is also increases. That's why here injected current, injected collector current is equal to the collector current. The maximum current injected collector current is directly proportional to the collector current. You can see here. This is the circuitry. This is similar circuitry. I am showing in PPT here the transistor. The arrow, it indicates the upper side, common base configuration. In a common base configuration, base is common. Common means it is connected through the ground. But the current is flowing through the emitter resistor because emitter terminal is heavily doped. That's why base to emitter junction, it is working as a forward bias. And base to collector junctions, the emitter collector terminal is moderate dope. That is, it's working in a reverse bias. Here the current I of C is flowing through the NPN transistor. What is mean by I of C? The input is applied between the emitter and base. Yes, in only NPN transistor you can see on that. Input is applied NPN base to emitter. And after the formation here the junction, that's called as the junction of base to emitter. And here the voltage is formed. Which voltage in the form of the region, this voltage is base emitter voltage. And here collector base voltage. Because of base is common in both the circuitry, NPN, also PNP. PNP is changing only arrow of the direction of the current. Current in a direction of the arrow, arrow is downwards, it's a PNP, and arrow is upwards in this diagram. Arrow is downwards. If the transistor arrow is downwards, then NPN transistor, and arrow is upwards, it's a PNP transistor. If the collector current IC, to measuring the output voltage of VCB, base collector voltage in the form of output current IC, output current is maximum because of collector is moderately low, that as compared to base terminal, that's why the collector current IC of the common base configuration, this is the common base configuration, base is lightly doped, means it is doping process is very slow as compared to the collector terminal. That's why total collector current I of C is equal to IC injected current. This is the injected current, current is flowing through the resistor. Injected current, injected collector current. I of C is equal to injected current plus ICBO. ICBO is common base output current. Common base output current. You can see here. The common base. This is meaning of the directional current IB. Directional current IB. The output I of C is equal to injected and the ICB. Common base collector. It's known as the current is going through the reversed bias. It is saturation region. That's why it is performed in a practically collector current IC is equal to injection. It is practically with perform. Collector current is approximately injected current. But the ICBO in a ICBO diode goes to in a collector terminal. In a NPN transistor, diode goes to reversed bias. In a second circuitry, common base collector terminal, the junction CB or BC, collector base junction, it goes to reverse bias. That's why in a PN transistor, it's open switch, and NP transistor here, NP transistor, it's forward bias, it is a closed switch. And PN transistor, this is the PN transistor, it is a reversed bias. That's why diode, it goes to reversed bias, diode goes to open switch. And the base to emitter junction is forward bias. And base to collector junction is reverse bias. That activation process is known as the transistor is a active region. Transistor is a active region. You can see here the features of common base configuration. Input two terminal, common terminal between input and output. Which terminal is common? The base terminal is common in the circuitry. Here, base terminal is common. Input current, IE, emitter resistor is the input current. Output current, it is a collector current. Output I of C, it is a collector because there are three terminal of transistor. Base terminal, we can use a input terminal. Then collector terminal, you can use for the output, and emitter terminal, you can use for the input. Base is the common input as well as output. Then input voltage, base emitter voltage is input. This is the base emitter voltage, output voltage, base emitter, base collector, it is the output voltage. Voltage gain, alpha DC, it is less than. What is mean by alpha DC? The direct current of the alpha DC. You can find out here the current amplification factor. Here, current amplification factor. How to find out the current amplification factor in ICBO? Output base collector current. After the transistor, it goes to open switch. transistor, it goes to open switch in NPN transistor, junction of base to collector terminal, base to collector. The current amplification factor or current gain in a CB configuration, it is a ratio of collector current. It is a ratio of collector current, I of C, divided by I of E, because of here the I of E is TJ input for passing the current, but the transistor it goes to open switch in a reversed bias. That's why it is formation in CB configuration in a collector current amplification factor. Current amplification factor or current gain is equal to alpha in a CB configuration. Then how to find out the alpha? Alpha is equal to collector current IC divided by the input current of IB is equal to, it is a ratio of collector current and the total input current. IE is equal to total input current. You can find out, sorry, can know that yesterday's lecture I can show on the total emitter current, or the emitter current is proportional to the sum of collector current and the base current. Then you can find out the alpha. Alpha is equal to collector and the emitter is known as the amplification factor, only current for alpha. Then alpha collector current is a IC divided by IE is equal to alpha DC. It is a because of IE collector current is greater than collector current, it is a lesser than the emitter current because it's a typically 0.95 or the less than 0.1. 0.95, it is a typically value for the alpha. And the input resistance RE. RE is the 20 kilo ohm. It is a low resistance. And output resistance, it is a high resistance. Because the meaning of transistor, the transistor, it is a transfer the low resistance path to the output resistance path, high output resistance path. Low input resistance is the RE, that's why 20 ohm, and output resistance is the 1 mega ohm high resistance value. And the amplification, it is a amplification you can use for the pre-amplifier. It is a application of CB configuration. Then similar for the CE configuration. Hello? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, you ma'am. Can understand CB configuration.
Yes, ma'am.
Those who have not understand, ask me, because of the another two configuration, CE configuration and the CC configuration. It is a base on CB configuration. First, you can understand CB configuration in detail thoroughly. Then you will understand the CE configuration and the CC configuration only based common emitter configuration. Then the common emitter, you can change your base. Base is the connected to the input and the emitter terminal is connected to the ground in a common CE configuration. And common collector, you can change your collector, common collector configuration. The collector, you can remove your output side connected through the ground common terminal, and our input is the base and output is the emitter, and the common is the collector. According to the here, I am showing the common base configuration. Here P regions, in a P region after the depletion in the formation of leakage current. What is mean by leakage current? You can see the current of ICBO, you know, understand already. ICBO, output, base, collector. This is the common base configuration, maximum electrons, and here also maximum electrons. If the junction is formation in CB, it is a forward bias because of electrons is created a positive charge and holes is created a negative charge. And the collector current I of E, collector current IE is a directly proportional to the sum of collector current and the base current, because the collector current is heavily doped. Emitter terminal is heavily doping process. Maximum all electrons is move in a holes and all holes is moving in a electrons. That's why here the junctions is formation in common emitter junction, and here the common base junction. You can see here the junction is formation. It see here a hole and here the junction, that is meaning of the recombination, and all red marks is the electrons in getting to the near region. Then the common electrons, this is also common electrons, and the base is the common, it is created a hole. The in the circuitry, here the circuitry you can see ICBU. ICBU. ICBU output. Output is the collector terminal. Output, base, collector, current. That is meaning of ICBU. If the transistor in a junction of first junction transistor, it goes to forward bias, and the junction of CB, the transistor goes to reverse bias. If the transistor goes to reverse bias, it is a open switch. Then the transistor, it works as an active region in BE. Base to emitter junction is forward bias, and base to collector junction is reverse bias. Then transistor, it works as an active. If the transistor is active, the switch is on, then it is a forward bias. Switch is off, it is works as a reverse bias. But the collector current is a maximum current because of maximum holes is generated in a collector terminal. In a N region, it's created a positive charge, and collector current IC is equal to injected collector current. That's why the injected collector current is a creating current amplification factor known as alpha. This alpha is directly proportional through the output current IC to the input current of total input current of IE, because of here IC is equal to IC is equal to IC. Here IE is equal to IC plus IB. IE is equal to IC plus IB. That's why in a common base configuration, the collector current is directly proportional to the, collector current is inversely proportional to the total input current. Alpha is a IC divided by IE. And here the junction is formation, the reverse saturation current flowing through the IB, ICBO. That's why here minority carriers between the collector and base terminal. Here the base is lightly doped because here generating the process is very slow for current flowing, and in a collector current, maximum current IC, it gets to the collector current of the injected current. That's why the current is going through the flowing through the saturation between the minority carriers between collector base. And when the emitter is open, here the emitter is open in a next configuration. and the junction collector. It is a bias collector base junction. ICBU is neglected or compared to the collector current. It is neglected or compared to the collector current. This current is known as the leakage current because the emitter current is a open switch and current ICBO. It's a saturation output base collector current. It create a minority carriers between collector and base. And minority carriers charge in a N region. In a N region. That's why the common base configuration IC is equal to injected current IC plus IBO. It is a current amplification factor only showing in books. This is the alpha DC is known as the current amplification factor. Alpha is equal to collector current. This is the collector current IC. Collector current IC plus injected current plus injected collector current ICBO. Because the current base and the collector current is create a minority carrier generate. And the negative region is created in a N region is created a maximum holes. That's why IC is equal to injected current is equal to alpha DC into IE. Injected current alpha DC into IE. Then the current amplification factor alpha DC is equal to IC divided by IE. Then it is value of the collector and base in a minority carrier charge that is equal to zero or negligible value. It is a small value. You can identify directly. It is a zero. That's why ICBA is zero. Then the alpha DC is equal to IC divided by I. It is a current amplification factor. You can show alpha DC is equal to IC plus IB. Here we have characteristics. You can see the characteristics. If the current is flowing in first circuitry, apply the voltage through the emitter terminal in the first junction, JE. This is the diagram of first JE. Current is flowing through the emitter terminal. Emitter terminal I, then through the RE resistor and the applied the voltage here. Then output voltage is directly showing here 8 volt. Because of that, it's a voltage versus current. Voltage is VBE. Is the voltage. V is the voltage. B is the base terminal. And E is the emitter terminal. If the voltage is increases, because of here the transistor it's on condition. After 0.7 volt diode go, sorry, transistor it's diode, it is a on 0.7 volt. And the two diodes you can use, NPN. Here in a transistor, we can use two diodes. One diode, it works in a forward bias. And another diode, it works in a reverse bias. That's why diode. Two diodes, you implement one transistor. If the transistor, it is a forward bias in first region, base to emitter junction, the 0.7 volt transistor is on, then current is flowing through the circuitry. The current is directly proportional to increased by IE, increased by IE, and IE is equal to some current of the base and the some current of the IC. That's why it's twice of the IC plus IB is equal to IE. And here the point, here 2 volt difference, VCB is increases for the 4 volt and VCB increases for the 8 volt. According to the voltages is increases, the current is also increases. And the amplification will possible in a small change input voltage because the input resistance is very low. In transistor is known as the low input resistance to the high input resistance. It is a input resistance is low and the current is flowing through the input low resistance to the output high resistance. That's why here low inputs for 0.0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. Then after that 0.7, the transistor is on. Then it's increasing the voltage. Then current is also increases. That is known as the IC is equal to IB plus IC. IE collector current IE is equal to base current IC, collector current IE. And here you can see the input resistance. Input resistance RE means RI. And input resistance is equal to delta VB. You can find out the delta. This is the slope. What is the slope in the first IE for the transition period? And after that, another point is the amplification point. That is known as the Q point or the DC operating point. You can find out here the slope of delta VB. Then input resistance is equal to delta VB, base emitter voltage. You can find out the delta divided by delta of input resistance. That is meaning of the input current is very large. This is input current because the emitter is highest or very high doping process. The maximum doping process is possible only emitter terminal. That's why all total current is converting to the base and the collector current. It is a small value of the resistance and the current is directly proportional to the collector current. Here you can see the effect of base width modulation. Base width modulation means the junction of JE and the junction of JC. Here the total bandwidth is increased, but the base terminal, all the collector N region, all electrons coming with P region, and here all electrons come with P region, and some of the holes in a P region, because of this is the NPN transistor, in a P region of the holes directly goes to the collector terminal. No single holes in N region. This is a open switch because the all junction or width is increases. Width is increased means the barrier potential voltage is increases. This is the meaning of the total base width. Width is increases, barrier potential voltages is increased, then the emitter terminal is open switch because of no single holes is apply here. All the holes is going through the collector terminal and the all electrons is coming in a base terminal in a P region. The P regions is act as a, it act as a negative region in holes, negative region in holes and the positive regions in a collector terminal. That why VCB it extremely increased because here combination of the junction, this is the wider depletion region, larger values of the collector base terminal. That's why here the naming of the punch through the collector base junction in output characteristic. This is the output characteristic. Here you can see it is the open switch in output side. Some output characteristics input in an input resistor. But emitter, in a region of emitter, the collector extremely large electrons is coming through the P region and holes is going through the collector's region. That's why here you can see the cutoff region 0.7 volt. This is the voltage in the both the junctions in a reverse bias. Both the junctions you can use in a reverse bias. The region is the base to emitter junction and base to collector correction junction. All both the junctions like a base to emitter and base to collector, it is a reverse bias. This is the dotted line. You can see the cutoff region. In a saturation region, this is the saturation region because of diode, it works in a 0.7 volt. Still transistor is not works in a 0.7. After 0.7 voltage is increased like a 0.8 volt, that's why the diode it goes to the active region. Here current I is equal to 10, then 1 milliampere, then it's increased 2 milliampere. According to the input voltage VBE in a forward bias, base emitter voltage is increases, the current is also increases. And here both the junctions directly goes to the reverse bias because the current ICBO here. This ICBO. IC is equal to ICBO. And this is the saturation current in a collector terminal. That's why here the saturation is possible in a collector region. And it is a transistor as used in a switch because first junction base to emitter junction, we can use a forward bias, and the base to collector junction, we can use a reverse bias. It is a active, some 0.7 volt transistor, it is act. Then the current is flowing through the emitter terminal. Emitter is heavily doped. That's why the maximum current is flowing through the emitter terminal. Emitter IE is equal to sum of the base terminal and the collector terminal. IB plus IC is equal to IE. That's why the collector terminal, it goes to the saturation region in a reversed bias. And here you can see the transfer characteristics or the Q points for the applying 1 volt current, 2 volt current, 3 volt current, 4 volt current. Current is equal to current because input current I is equal to output current IC. Current I is directly proportional to the current amplification factor alpha DC. This is the slope you can see here. Current IE is equal to current IC, and the current I is a total current of the collector current, that is meaning of the current amplification factor alpha DC, and slope you can indicate for the delta. It is meaning of the slope for the difference between two input signal. And base to collector voltage here constant means voltage is constant because only identify the current, because BJT, it is current controlled device. That's why BJT, NPN BJT transistor, we can use current control device. And here input characteristic IB and VBE, base to emitter voltage, base to induct current in a microampere. If the 0.7 transistor, it has an act, then current is flowing, then current is directly proportional to the input voltage. It is a dynamic NPN transistor. You can see here the VBE, here common, base is common, supply voltage, emitter resistor, base resistor. Because base is common, then delta input resistance is directly proportional to the delta input constant. And collector is the open switch, that's why it is a constant. You can identify only input characteristic. Here you can see the output characteristics. Output, outputs across measuring the collector terminal. Inputs, we can use measuring for the base terminal because this configuration is the common base configuration. And emitter terminal, it's a input of the current, total current of the circuitry. And direct input output characteristic, this is the input output characteristic. You can find out the beta. Beta is directly proportional to the collector current into input current, means output current divided by input current. And same diagram, you can see the input current is increases, the voltage is also increasing. If voltage is 1, 2, 3, according to the voltage is 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt, 4 volt, according to the voltage is increases in VCE, this is the output characteristics. Here you can see the output voltage VCE, then the current of the input base current is increasing. And this configuration is known as the active region. And 0.7 volt diode, it's a conduction state. This is a 0.7 volt, is a saturation region. Both the region goes to the reversed bias. In saturation region, both the regions forward bias, base to emitter is forward bias and base to collector is reverse bias. It is an active region. And the base to emitter is the forward bias and base to collector, it is also forward bias. It is a cutoff region. This dotted line, it is a cutoff region. Here saturation region and here active region. And here alpha DC, same characteristics, transfer characteristic, IC plus IB, you can find out the delta or the slope of the Q point in a configuration. In next lecture, you can see the detail. Common emitter. Emitter is common in a CE configuration. This is the emitter is common in a CE configuration. Then this configuration you can find out the beta, and the common configuration is the base. You can find out the alpha. Then next lecture we will continue for the next point. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Point is understanding or not? CE configuration and the CE configuration. CB is the common base and CE is the common emitter. If the base is common, then the current is flowing through the emitter to collector. And the emitter is common, then current is flowing through the base to collector. Base is common, you can find out the current factor. Alpha DC is equal to alpha IC divided by IE. And the current factor is beta, then you can use for the configuration common emitter, CE configuration. And beta DC is equal to IC, collector current divided by input current IB. Okay. Here I am stop the recording.